हेलो चेक, आई बिलीव वी आर लाइव पीपल, बट द थिंग इज माई स्क्रीन इज नॉट वर्किंग अपेरेंटली.
कुछ तो है यहाँ पे
द टच इज नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली. लेट मी जस्ट चेक. या जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट, इट शुड बी फिक्स्ड.
अभी चल रहा है. हाँ चल पड़ा. यप.
सो पीपल, टुडे वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस अनदर यू नो class of chemical kinetics, and today we will be done with the theory of chemical kinetics. Today we are about to understand what is collision theory, what is Arrhenius equation, and once we understand that, the theory of this chapter is over. Then the next class, which is there on Friday, what we will do in that class is that we will simply try to solve lots of questions from this particular chapter. Yeah, so quickly let me just fix the focus as well. Aapka comment section mere ko apne laptop pe lane do. है ना जी. सिद्धार्थ साहब सिंह, आपकी डुकाटी डियाबल का माइलेज कितना है? दोस्त, ऑन द हाईवे इट गिव्स मी एनी वेयर फ्रॉम 16 to 18. इन द सिटी इट कैन बी एज लो एज 5 and 6 एज वेल. सो अब ये बस कैमरा सेट करने दो दोस्तों, क्योंकि ये हिल जाता है बैठे बैठाए. यू नो आई हैव टू कैट्स एंड दे विल चेंज द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द कैमरा एवरी डे. या तो कैट्स हिला देती हैं या तो सफाई वाली आंटी हिला देती हैं, तो ये कैमरा कभी सीधा रहता ही नहीं है. एनी वे पीपल, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वेटिंग वंस अगेन. एंड सम ऑफ यू आर वंडरिंग व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग क्लासेस एट 8 PM दीज डेज रादर देन 7 PM. यार दिन में थोड़े काम ज़्यादा हो जाते हैं, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग क्लासेस एट 8. एनी वे, आई होप द स्क्रीन इज नाइस एंड विजिबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू नाउ. थोड़ा सा साइड पे है, बट आई थिंक वी आर गुड टू गो. Cool. So people, in the previous few classes of chemical kinetics, what have we learned? We've learned about different types of orders of the reaction. Yeah, first order reaction, second order reaction, zeroth order reaction. We've learned what is half-life. We've solved a bunch of questions as well. And there was a homework question that I gave you, and the answer to that homework question is 2, by the way. So in case you guys have forgotten to solve that homework question, please go back and solve that. It had just a few numbers given to you. यहाँ पे नंबर्स ये ऐसे दे रखे थे. या दिस वाज व्हाट वाज द होमवर्क क्वेश्चन. सो द नंबर्स एटसेट्रा गिवन, यू बेसिकली हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ द ए नॉट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू टी हाफ. एंड वंस यू डू दैट, आई थिंक यू विल फाइंड आउट दैट द ऑर्डर ऑफ दिस रिएक्शन इज 2. सो वी विल सी द नेम्स ऑफ अ फ्यू पीपल हु हैव गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर लेटर. पहले आते हैं कोलिजन थ्योरी पे. इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन द रेट ऑफ अ रिएक्शन, दैट्स वॉट वी आर ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड राइट नाउ. दैट If I increase the temperature or if I decrease the temperature, how will the rate be affected? That's what chemical kinetics is about, right? Rate. तो चलो दोस्तों, आज कहानी बनाते हैं. Today is a storytelling class and you will have a lot of fun if you listen to the story carefully. Yeah. How does a reaction happen? When species A is reacting with species B, how do they react? Physically, what is the process that is happening in their reaction? असलियत में वो किस प्रकार से टकरा रहे हैं कि रिएक्शन हो जाए. या कैन यू टेल मी अनुज? यस, वी विल लर्न अबाउट आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन टुडे, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट आर्हेनियस थ्योरी ऑफ एसिड्स एंड बेसिस, दैट्स गोइंग टू बी कवर्ड इन आयनिक इक्विलिब्रियम. बट राइट नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन दैट हैज टू डू विद द रेट्स ऑफ अ रिएक्शन. ओके. Unadvised is asking, is tattva enough for J advanced? Yet, yes, it is pretty good. I mean, you can do more practice, of course. Yeah. So, what do you think? How does a reaction happen? See, the thing is, all right, when two things are supposed to react with each other, I'm just looking for some people, giving me some answer. As Siddharth is saying, they should be at a proper alignment. Okay, fine. ये एक चीज आ गई, proper alignment. Amulya is saying by colliding. Okay. So Amulya is saying they should collide. Siddharth is saying they should collide in a proper alignment. So collision is one factor. Alignment is one factor. What else could be the factor? What else could be the factor? Yeah. पहले तो collision हुआ. Okay. Collision should happen. Otherwise, how will the reaction happen? Yeah. If A is going to react with B, will the reaction happen if they don't collide at all? No. This guy has to collide with this guy so that the reaction happens. So the thing is, collision matters, and along with the collision, let's say this hand wants to react with this hand to do something like this. Yes, if I orient this hand like this, will the reaction happen? No, this is a useless collision. या सो मेनी डिफरेंट कोलिजन्स आर पॉसिबल फ्रॉम ऑल डायरेक्शंस, ओनली दिस कोलिजन मैटर्स. सो वन आइडिया इज ऑफ अ कोलिजन टेकिंग प्लेस, टकराना जरूरी है. देन द सेकेंड थिंग इज दे शुड कोलाइड विद द करेक्ट अलाइनमेंट. थर्ड थिंग इज एज सिद्धार्थ इज पॉइंटिंग आउट, या एंड देवु इज ऑल्सो पॉइंटिंग आउट, वेरी नाइस. या सिद्धार्थ और देवु बोल रहे हैं बिल्कुल सही चीज. सिद्धार्थ एंड देवु आर पॉइंटिंग आउट दैट द एनर्जी शुड बी इनफ. माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, डू यू रिमेंबर द क्या कहते हैं उनको, ग्राफ्स ऑफ एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी? डू यू रिमेंबर दोज केसेस? एक एम्प्टी स्लाइड बनाता हूं मैं. Yeah, let me make an empty slide over here and then we'll look at what the slides say. The slides also have a very good amount of text written in them. So on this empty page, let this go away. Let me try to remind you of something. Do you remember these type of graphs? This was basically the energy. This was basically the reaction coordinate. This is the energy of your reactant. थोड़ा यहीं पे बना देते हैं. This is your reactant energy. This is your product's energy. Yeah, you must have done this in organic chemistry. If you've studied organic with me, I'm pretty sure I've told you about this in SN1, SN2, E1, E2 as well. Yeah, and then this particular point is basically your transition state. Isn't it? That particular point is your transition state, and this amount of energy that is required to go from the reactant to the transition state, this particular energy is known as activation energy. Even though the products are lower in energy than the reactants, overall what will happen is this reaction will be exothermic. Do you realize this overall reaction will be exothermic because reactants are at higher energy, products are at lower energy. So overall in this reaction, energy will be released. But initially to start this reaction, you have to give some amount of energy. Then you will get this much amount of energy back. Ye yaad hai graphs? Yeah, I'm pretty sure you guys have seen these graphs somewhere or the other. Maybe you've seen it in some book, maybe you've seen it with my classes, maybe you've seen it in school, etc., etc. तो ये तो आपको याद होगा. दिस इज नोन एज एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी. फाइन, एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी इज बेसिकली द मिनिमम एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द रिएक्टेंट्स टू रीच द ट्रांजिशन स्टेट सो दैट दे कैन गो टू द प्रोडक्ट्स. एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी इज द मिनिमम एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अ रिएक्शन टू गो फॉरवर्ड. फाइन, सो राइट नाउ वी हैव थ्री फैक्टर्स विद विच अ सक्सेसफुल रिएक्शन कैन हैपन. आई एम गोना इरेज दिस पार्ट पीपल. ओके, right now I have three different factors with which a proper collision, a proper reaction can happen. Okay, so there is species A which wants to react with species B. What is the first factor? First factor is they should collide. Takkar hogi tabhi kuch hoga. Yeah, so first factor is they should collide. We'll write it like that. They should collide. Fine, very obvious. The second thing is that they should collide with a proper orientation. Yeah, if this is my hand, this is my hand, they should collide with this orientation. If my hands are going around in random motion, they can, you know, collide in any particular direction. Only one of these so many collisions would be a proper collision. Yeah, not every collision will give you a reaction. Only one particular collision will give you a reaction. So they should align with proper orientation. They will have to collide with proper alignment. And the third thing is, yeah, they should first of all collide. They should have a proper orientation. And third thing is, they should carry enough energy. Okay, so yahan likh dunga, should carry enough energy to form the transition state. So these are the three factors. Do you understand? Everyone agrees with these factors? Yeah. Do you guys agree with these factors? It's like two people, meeting each other. Yeah. Two people meeting each other, can they become friends? Depends on a lot of things. First of all, if there are two random people in the world, what is the criteria for them to become friends? First of all, they should be able to meet each other. Yeah. So, pehle to pass mein aana zaruri hai unka. Yeah. They should come close to each other. They should have a conversation with each other. Second thing is they should collide with a proper orientation. Ye na ho ki this person is going in this direction, this person is going in this direction. They did come close, but they did not have a proper collision. Yeah. They did not start interacting with each other. This guy is going here, this guy is going here. They just came close, but not in proper alignment. And then they should carry enough energy. They should actually, want a new friend. Did you get the idea? Like, why would I talk to someone else if I am not interested in talking to that person? Something like that. I need to have enough energy. I need to have enough enthusiasm so that I can strike a conversation with someone else. And if that person also matches my enthusiasm, then perhaps we will become friends. Make sense? Real life example do to chamak gaya, simple ho gaya. So same thing yahan pe atoms ke saath ho rahi hai, molecules ke saath ho rahi hai, unko collide karna jaruri hai. Sahi tarike se collide karna jaruri hai aur achhi khasi energy se collide karna jaruri hai. Yeah. Jyoshika, the live classes for 2022 students happen on Tuesday, Thursdays and Saturdays. There was one yesterday, there's going to be one tomorrow as well. Okay. Got it? Yes, people? Understood? I hope so. Now, given these ideas in our mind, we will try to associate mathematics with each of these points. Yeah, we will try to associate some mathematics with each of these points, and that mathematics will help us understand how the kinetics of a reaction may change with temperature. All right, let's go forward. Zaruri means necessary. Okay, chalo. So let's read about this particular page. So one by one, we'll read whatever theory is given on these pages. Collision theory, effect of temperature on the rate of a reaction. We take an assumption. The reaction is bimolecular, which means that only two molecules are interacting, and it is in gaseous phase. This is an assumption to understand collision theory. Okay, you can take infinite number of molecules that are reacting with each other. You can take a trimolecular, polymolecular reaction as well. But it is easier for us to imagine a bimolecular reaction. Cool. So the reaction is bimolecular and it is in gaseous phase. Fine. If someone tells you, guess how many collisions are happening per second in gaseous phase? Collisions per second are 10 to the power 30. Lots of collisions. 10 to the power 30. Oi, oi, oi. In 1 second, in a gaseous environment, in normal standard conditions, there are so many collisions that are happening. You can't even imagine this number of collisions. Yeah. 1 crore कितना होता है? 10 to the power 6, 10 to the power 7, कुछ ऐसा ही होता है. 10 to the power 7, I guess, yeah. 10 to the power 30. करोड़ का भी बाप है ये. So there are so many collisions happening inside a gaseous system at just normal temperature, and the thing is that out of all of these collisions, will all the collisions be successful? No. Fraction of successful collisions is very small at room temperature. These collisions might not carry enough energy. No reaction will happen. These collisions might not carry proper orientation. No reaction will happen. So first of all, you need to give them more energy. And then they will maybe do this kind of a collision. Make sense? This is exactly what we discussed. So, the success of collision depends upon two main important factors. Do they have sufficient energy and are they properly oriented? This is something that we discussed. Great. So, pehli baat aati hai energy factor. The collision should possess certain minimum amount of energy to get converted into products. The minimum energy is called threshold energy. Now, I will ask you guys a question. Okay. I will ask you guys a question. Ignore the horns from the highway. Do you remember a mathematical model? Okay, do you remember a mathematical model for velocities of ideal gas molecules. याद है कुछ? See, energy for gaseous molecules is simply equal to half mv square. Because they possess only kinetic energy. If you assume ideal gas, life is very simple. They possess only kinetic energy. So for an ideal gas, do you remember what is this mathematical model called? इस मॉडल को क्या कहते हैं? रिशद भाई YouTube पर चिल मारो. रिशद इज आस्किंग, डू यू हैव एनी टिप्स फॉर JEE 2024? डोंट वरी टू मच अबाउट इट. बताओ, डू यू रिमेंबर व्हाट्स दिस मॉडल? या आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू आंसर रैंडम पीपल हु आर जस्ट स्पैमिंग द चैट बॉक्स पॉइंटलेसली. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट आई एम टीचिंग ऑन द बोर्ड, सो आई कांट look at your queries all the time. Second thing is, if you were in an offline class, would you just shout one question 20 times at the teacher? Is that a polite way to ask a question? No, right? So spammers, sorry, not entertaining that idea. Siddharth is saying something Boltzmann. Okay, Siddharth, you are very close. Yeah. Harshini, PV equal to NRT, nahi dost. I am talking about a mathematical model. Yeah, Siddharth ne hint de diya hai. Siddharth is giving a hint. Siddharth says something Boltzmann. What Boltzmann? Amole saying kinetic theory of gases. Absolutely. What was the mathematical distribution? Aisa graph yaad hai? Ye wala graph yaad hai? Do you understand this graph? Do you remember this graph rather? What distribution is this? ASD, very good. Juhi, very nice. Juhi, not exactly correct. Balaji, absolutely correct, man. Yeah. Bilkul sahi. Invincible Tushar, that's absolutely correct. We are talking about the Maxwell-Boltzmann's distribution. Okay. Maxwell-Boltzmann's distribution will give us ideas about the energies of these molecules. Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. Yaad aaya kuch? Do you now remember what I mean to say? Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. Yeah, this is going to tell us how many gaseous molecules possess enough energy to react. Aise kitne molecule hain jinse reaction ho sakta hai. Yeah, so I'm going to erase this. And let me make a graph for you. Yeah, this is the graph. Remember, this is what the graph looks like approximately. थोड़ा और अच्छे से बना देता हूँ. Yeah, something like this is what the graph looks like. And what we have is basically on the y-axis we have the fraction of molecules. Yeah, and on the x-axis we have velocities. Higher velocity implies higher energy. We understand that because kinetic energy is the only component of energy that these gaseous molecules possess. That's what ideal gas theory says. Now people, do you understand that only a certain number of molecules, only a certain fraction of molecules will be able to react? Let us assume, okay, this is an assumption now. This can be determined experimentally. The assumption is that this particular point, okay, this particular point marks the threshold energy. Do you understand why am I saying threshold energy? See, only beyond this point you will possess enough energy so that you can react. Iske piche jitne bhi molecule hain, उनकी वेलोसिटी बहुत कम है. ऑल द मॉलिक्यूल्स बिलो दिस पॉइंट हैव वेरी लेस एनर्जी. ओनली मॉलिक्यूल्स अबव दिस पॉइंट हैव इनफ एनर्जी दैट व्हेन दे कोलाइड दे विल कॉज अ रिएक्शन. या अंडरस्टूड? सो इफ दिस इज द थ्रेशोल्ड एनर्जी, दिस इज द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट कैन रिएक्ट. मॉलिक्यूल्स दैट can react. Yeah, only these molecules have enough energy that they can reach the transition state and go to the product side. Understood? Yeah, molecules that can react. This is the fraction of molecules that has that high amount of energy. Now people, what happens to the curve when I increase the temperature? Yaad hi hoga aap logon ko, hai na? Do you remember what happens to the curve when I increase the temperature? The curve flattens out, yeah, but the number of molecules, ye thoda ghatiya sa ban gaya mere se. Yeah. Ignore my drawing skills, yeah. The graph will flatten out basically. Yeah, the new blue curve that I've drawn. This red one was the original graph. But when I increase the temperature, the blue one is the new graph. Can you see that? Ye blue wala jo line banaya, this is the new graph. This is at higher temperature. This is T low. This is T high. When I increase the temperature, I am pretty sure you can see by the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution that the number of molecules that contain enough energy have increased. Now, does it make sense that increasing temperature will increase the speed of the reaction as we had discussed in the previous class? Priya, yes, the classes are helpful for NEET as well. Rishit, absolutely correct, man. Neeraj, can you tell me what part you want me to repeat? Otherwise, you can just rewind the class if there is an entire section you want to listen to again. Yeah. Harshini, so we are not talking about the ease of collision right now. We are just talking about the fact that there are more molecules with higher energy. Of course, with increasing temperature, the collisions will also increase. Yeah, because their velocities will increase. Wohi baat hogi. Yeah, so what you are saying is also correct. Siddharth is saying, can excessive energy of molecules inhibit a reaction? See, it is possible in a manner that they start doing some other reaction. Okay, let's say there are two pathways starting from the same reactant. One pathway needs this much activation energy, another pathway needs this much activation energy, and you are getting two different products, let's say. This is product number one, this is product number two. So if you give it this amount of activation energy, then product one will get formed. If you give it a lot of activation energy, then a different product might get formed. Yeah, so that is how reaction one can get inhibited. Some other thing will happen. Or maybe they just destroy the entire molecule. You give it such high energy that the molecule itself gets destroyed and, you know, nothing can happen further. So energy ka idea aayega Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution se. So we'll see the mathematics of it very soon. I hope you understood graphically what I mean. This is the orientation factor or the steric factor. Steric happens to be, chemistry, you know what steric hindrance is. Hindrance because of crowding, bulkiness, etc. So orientation and approach is steric. Okay, whenever we have to give a singular word for orientation and how two things are approaching each other, we call it steric. So orientation matters, steric matters. Yeah. So the molecules participating in the collisions must be properly aligned. You guys told me in the beginning itself. Let's see this particular case. NO plus O3. Yeah. NO plus O3 have to give you NO2 plus O2. This is the reaction. What is the reaction that we want to do? We want to do NO plus O3 to give me NO2 plus O2. Ye reaction karna cha rahe hum. NO plus O3 to give me NO2 plus O2. Okay, simplistic, very simplistic reaction. So in the first case, can you see the collision does not make sense? Yeah, the oxygen comes close to oxygen. Pointless collision, you will get back your NO and O3 again. Yeah, this nitrogen comes close to the middle oxygen, again does not make sense. This particular collision, the nitrogen comes close to the topmost oxygen. It captures that topmost oxygen from here. Yeah, the bottom two oxygens just go out like O2. Ineffective collisions, effective collision. ये भी मस्त हो गया एकदम. भव्य, वील डू दोज थिंग्स, डोंट वरी. वील डू दोज थिंग्स इन द केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड आयनिक इक्विलिब्रियम चैप्टर्स, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट एट ऑल. धीरे धीरे सब पता लग जाएगा. सिद्धार्थ, अगेन लेट मी टेल यू दैट दिस इज द केमिकल. There are some random trucks on the highway. Yeah, let me remind you, Siddharth, that this is the chapter of chemical kinetics. We're not worried about stability at all. We are thinking about the speed of a reaction. स्टेबिलिटी वील थिंक अबाउट इट सम अदर टाइम, वी हैव ऑलरेडी थॉट ऑफ इट इन थर्मोडायनामिक्स. या आई डोंट केयर वेदर माई प्रोडक्ट इज स्टेबल, इवन इफ इट फॉर्म्स फॉर वन सेकेंड, ओके फाइन, आई जस्ट नीड टू डू दैट रिएक्शन. सो वी आर वरिड अबाउट द स्पीड ओवर हियर, नॉट द स्टेबिलिटी. ओके, एंड स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स ऑल्सो डज नॉट रियली मैटर फॉर एनी थिंग. या कोई खास फर्क पड़ता नहीं है स्टेबिलिटी से ऑन द काइनेटिक्स. स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द ट्रांजिशन स्टेट माइट बी रेलिवेंट टू काइनेटिक्स बिकॉज द एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी दैट यू नीड माइट गेट लोअर्ड. दैट आइडिया. चलो जी, नीलम सिंह एस एन टू में ऐसा होता है. एब्सोल्यूटली नीलम, वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल नीलम सिंह, दैट एस एन टू में भी ऐसा ही होता है. यस, एस एन टू में इफ द न्यूक्लियोफाइल अप्रोचेस फ्रॉम द बैक साइड ओनली देन द रिएक्शन हैपेंस. इफ द न्यूक्लियोफाइल अप्रोचेस फ्रॉम द फ्रंट साइड इट कांट अप्रोच. एब्सोल्यूटली करेक्ट. या सो कोलिजन फैक्टर भी हो गया, स्टेरिक फैक्टर भी हो गया, वी आर रिपीटिंग द सेम थिंग्स अगेन एंड अगेन. या सो नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट गिविंग सम नंबर्स टू थिंग्स. Are you ready to give some numbers logically? थोड़ा number वंबर देते हैं, ठीक है, number देते हैं थोड़े से. तो let me go back to this empty slide. तीन factor जो थे अपने उसको number देने हैं. Okay. First factor was collision should happen. Yeah. Second factor was energy should be enough. And third factor was alignment. Right, collision factor. Okay, let's talk about collisions. Number of collisions would be proportional to what? Yeah, for collisions, let's talk about the number of collisions. Number of collisions would be proportional to the number of molecules. Yeah, if inside a local train there are only two people, one person will sit there, one person will sit there. They will have enough space. They don't want to look at each other. They're looking out the window. Great. But if you go to your Mumbai local at 6 p.m., 7 p.m., yeah, or any other local bus or whatever, you know how crowded those get in the evenings. There's no space because there are so many people, more collisions will be there. Yeah. So collisions are basically proportional to the number of molecules. Can I say that the number of collisions are basically going to be proportional to the concentrations of reactants? Yeah, बात बनती है कि नहीं? Number of collisions would be proportional to the concentration of the reactants. If concentration of A and B, the reactants that are reacting, if concentration is A is high, B is high, more collisions will happen. If concentration of A is less, then B will go around, then one of A will react someday, then another A will come and attack someday, another A will come and collide someday. But if A are also high, the number of A is high, and I look like a weird maniac doing these things. If you look at this video while muting it, you will be dying with fits of laughter. The point is ki yaar, more concentration means more collisions. Yeah, so number of collisions is proportional to concentrations of the reactants. Yeah, so can I say that this thing would be proportional to concentration of A into concentration of B? Basically concentration of reactants. I'm taking a very simplistic case over here. You can say A to the power A, B to the power B as well. है ना, ठीक है. मोर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स इंप्लाइज मोर कोलिजन्स. वॉट आर दी स्मॉल ए स्मॉल बी? स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट्स, एज वी हैव बीन डूइंग टिल नाउ, लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन. ठीक है, सो नंबर ऑफ कोलिजन्स आर प्रोपोर्शनल टू ए टू द पावर ए इनटू बी टू द पावर बी. ओके, ग्रेट. एनर्जी कहां से आएगा? दिस विल कम फ्रॉम द मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. इसको अपन एमबीडी बोलेंगे अभी, एंड विल कीप इट एट अ साइड. आई विल गिव यू अ वैल्यू फॉर दिस एनर्जी फैक्टर एज वेल, वी विल थिंक अबाउट लेटर. एंड अलाइनमेंट. For alignment, let me rephrase this word and I'll call it probability of alignment. Okay? Probability of alignment. Yeah? That's the point, right? Out of 100 collisions, only let's say 3 would be of good quality. Out of 200 collisions, only maybe 15 would be of good quality. It depends on the reaction. Depends on the shapes of the molecules. Yeah. If there is too much steric hindrance, then the proper collision might not happen. If there is very less steric hindrance, then the proper collision will happen. Again, remember SN2 reaction. So probability of alignment, let us just call it P. Simple as that. Probability lies between 0 and 1. या सो इन सम पर्टिकुलर रिएक्शन प्रोबेबिलिटी माइट बी 0.3 एट अ सर्टन टेम्परेचर, है ना. प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ प्रॉपर अलाइनमेंट ऑफ कोलिजन, सम प्रोबेबिलिटी विल बी देयर. सो collisions are proportional to a to the power a b to the power b, basically the concentration reactance. Energy factor upon discuss karenge, we'll discuss this in 2 minutes. And alignment probability p, how do we calculate this probability? It is an experimental thing to do. Chalo to wapas aate hain on to that text. Here text aa gaya apna. So collision frequency, let's consider an example, a plus b going to products. Elementary reaction rate law will be r, that is equal to k into a to the b. This is something that we've learned. Collision frequency is the number of collisions taking place per second per unit volume at a given temperature. So number of collisions will be proportional to the concentration of colliding species. Collision frequency is proportional to A into B. We can write it as Z times A into B, where Z can be called collision frequency constant. Unnecessary. This is enough. Okay, collision frequency proportional to A into B, that is enough. I hope you understood this part. If you have any doubts, please ask me. I am going a little slow so that everyone can understand, okay? Because this theory is something that people generally ignore because they don't understand it well. I'm going slowly and steadily so that everyone can understand. If you need me to go fast, then tell me, I'll go fast. ठीक है? Okay, Neelam is saying, does the collision depend on the average speed or some other speed? See, you can talk about any speed. More speed, if average speed is more, most probable speed will be more. Every speed will be higher, yeah? So, no need to think about a particular kind of speed. Okay. If we are fighting, we're saying, will loss of energy take place? See, in reality, it does. Okay. In reality, it does to a certain extent. But we are talking about ideal cases, so no need to think about loss of energy. All the collisions over here, we will consider them to be elastic collisions. Yeah. Fine. Siddharth is saying, does it have to do with plane of symmetry and center of symmetry? Not really, Siddharth. We are not going into that much amount of detail. Okay. Someone is asking, Vishwanadham is asking, sir, this topic is removed from CBSE syllabus. Why are you teaching it? Because it is not removed from JEE syllabus. Competitive exams will still have proper full syllabus. Okay. Why are you only speaking of elementary reactions, Devu? Because it is easy for us to understand. Why do we always talk about ideal gases? Because they are easy to understand. ठीक है, चलो. तो ये हो गया collision frequency. Then energy factor comes from only the molecules having energy more than the threshold energy, as we had seen, result in successful collisions. My dear friends, this particular thing is a fact for you. अब ये जो है ना, you have to remember this as a fact. Okay, what is this fact? Let me tell you. Fraction of molecules. Okay. Fraction of molecules having energy more than activation energy. Okay, this is activation energy. Activation energy ko main kaise likhunga? I'll write activation energy as energy of activation, EA. Fraction of molecules having energy more than activation energy according to the Boltzmann distribution is equal to, okay, E raised to the power minus sign that specific energy value, okay, activation energy divided by RT. As I de rakha yahan, yeah, same thing is given over here. Do you understand? This is something that we need to keep in our mind as a fact. You must be saying, sir, can you tell us how to derive it? I'll give you an idea. Ek idea de deta hu aapko iski derivation kaise hoti hai. Okay, so this is your Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. It's a Wikipedia page. Okay, so this is the kind of graph that we've seen. All right, and do you see the sheer amount of mathematics that is here? So let's go to the distribution function. This is the function. Okay, this is the mathematical function. Ye equation hai us function ka. या लाइक यू स्टडी स्ट्रेट लाइन इक्वेशन, लाइक यू स्टडी हाइपरबोला, पैराबोला, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. या दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ द मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. एंड यू विल बी लाइक, सर व्हाई इज इट सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड? इट इज सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बिकॉज दिस इज अ थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस इक्वेशन. Yeah, this is not a one-dimensional curve. This is basically a three-dimensional curve. ठीक है, ये three dimension में gases you know are moving in three dimensions. It talks about the velocity of those in three different dimensions essentially. Okay, so काफी मजेदार सा हो जाता है. If you think about Maxwell distribution only for particles in one direction, then this is the equation. Yeah, काफी खतरनाक सा गंदा सा equation है. So the point is that Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution, the equations of it are a little difficult for us. इतनी अच्छी बात नहीं है कि हम उनको अभी पढ़ना शुरू कर दें. It's not a very good idea for us to start studying those in detail right now. Cool? Kavya, you always have my permission, bacha. So Kavya, what you need to do is just give a comment on this video later. ठीक है, जब ये वीडियो खत्म हो जाएगा, व्हेन द लाइव स्ट्रीम इज ओवर, जस्ट रिफ्रेश द लिंक, यू विल गेट माय कमेंट सेक्शन ऑफ द वीडियो. जस्ट टेल मी व्हाटएवर यू हैव टू टेल ओवर देयर. ओके, डोंट वरी एट ऑल, आई विल डेफिनेटली पास ऑन योर फीडबैक. प्रद्युम्ना, वी हैव बीन टीचिंग ऑन दिस चैप्टर स्टिल फ्रॉम मे में शुरू हो गई थी भाई क्लासेस. वी हैव डन टू मेनी चैप्टर्स ऑलरेडी. प्लीज वॉच द वीडियोस ऑफ अदर क्लासेस एज वेल. ओके, अमृत, ग्राफ के लिए ब्रदर यू विल हैव टू रिवाइज योर गैसियस स्टेट चैप्टर. ओके, दैट मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ग्राफ, इट इज देयर इन द काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस. देयर आर क्लासेस ऑफ दैट ऑन दिस चैनल एज वेल. जस्ट सर्च फॉर काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस पाहुल सर, यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर. ओके, तो वो आपको रिवाइज करना पड़ेगा खुद से दोस्त. अभी के लिए राइट नाउ वी डोंट हैव इनफ टाइम टू स्टार्ट यू नो talking about the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. So fraction of molecules having energy more than this activation energy, more than x bhi agar likhna hai, so this is equal to e to the power minus x by rt. Got the idea? Yeah, fraction of molecules having energy more than let's say 10 joules will be equal to e to the power minus 10 by rt. Get the idea? That is something that we get from the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. So no need to worry about it. ठीक है, सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वंस अगेन गोइंग बैक टू द क्लीन क्लियर पेज, खाली पेज पे जाते हैं, वील राइट समथिंग एंड देन वील रिलेटेड टू द आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन. ठीक है, खाली पेज पे जाते हैं और फिर उसको आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन बना देंगे. वेरी सिंपल. या सो आई विल राइट द सेम थिंग्स वंस अगेन. Rate of a reaction will basically be, you know, equal to the number of collisions. Yeah, more collisions, more would be the speed of the reaction. Yeah, into the energy of each collision, or energy, yeah, aise bolna chahiye yahan pe, fraction of collisions above threshold energy or activation energy. Yeah, collisions should happen, more collisions, more reaction, more speed of the reaction. If those collisions have high energy, then again the speed of the reaction will be higher, into probability, yeah, of correct alignment. This is it. Rate of the reaction will be proportional to collisions, fraction of collisions above a threshold energy, and probability of correct alignment. These numbers we have already defined. Number of collisions is basically equal to some collision factor k into a to the power a into b to the power b. Basically the concentrations of the reactants, more concentration, more collisions. Energy factor we just saw. Energy factor was basically e to the power minus ea by rt. This is the fraction of collisions that have higher energy than the activation energy, comes from the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution, into probability p. Yeah, दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी कैन राइट वेरी इजिली, दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी कैन राइट बाय मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, दिस इज समथिंग दैट डिपेंड्स ऑन द मूड ऑफ द रिएक्शन, दिस इज समथिंग दैट डिपेंड्स, वी कैन असर्टेन इट ओनली वाया एन एक्सपेरिमेंट. या what's the probability of correct alignment? Again, if there is more steric hindrance, probability will be less. If there is less steric hindrance, probability will be more. What's the exact number of probability? It doesn't really matter to us. Cool? Adarsh, I would always choose an IIT, brother. But I'll talk about that. People, don't worry. I'll talk about college versus branch. I will make a separate video on it. Aaj nahi to kal bana dunga. Theek hai? Toh ye dekho. This comes out to be P into K, this is your collision constant, okay? This is not rate constant, this is collision constant. ठीक है, तो इसको you can call it something else as well. This is collision constant, not rate constant. So probability factor into collision constant into a to the power a into b to the power b into e to the power minus ea by rt. This is rate, and from the law of mass action. Yeah, this is from collision theory. From the law of mass action, we already know the rate is equal to the rate constant of the reaction. We'll write it as small k. Okay, we'll write it as a small k into a to the power a into b to the power b. This is the law of mass action. This is collision factor. Understood? Law of mass action, collision theory. We can equate those things because both the things are talking about the rate. So, yahan se cancel kya ho ja raha hai? We can see that this part gets cancelled out. So, what am I getting? I am getting that the rate constant for any reaction is equal to the probability factor into the collision constant into e to the power minus ea by rt. My dear friends, this particular equation can also be written as, जो यहां लिखूंगा दैट इज व्हाट्स इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, दिस इक्वेशन कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज रेट कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ अ रिएक्शन के इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस ऑफ एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी डिवाइडेड बाय आर टी. दिस ए माई डियर फ्रेंड्स इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द आर्हेनियस कॉन्स्टेंट. दिस पर्टिकुलर ए इज वॉट वी कॉल द आर्हेनियस constant. And you know what the fun thing is? Arrhenius had actually worked on this law empirically. Arrhenius ne thoda Maxwell Boltzmann ka idea laga ke, yeah, he took a little bit of idea from Maxwell Boltzmann and then he gave this law empirically via experiment. He thought only about the collision about the energy factor, and then this one he just gave as a constant value for different reactions. Yeah, different reactions have different values of Arrhenius constant. So, do you realize that this particular equation gives you the association of a rate constant with temperature? Can you see? If you increase the temperature, the rate constant will also increase. Dekh lo ek bar dhyan se. So, my dear friends, the thing is that Arrhenius had thought only about the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution and then associated a constant and gave the Arrhenius equation. Then further a few people more started thinking about the collision and probability, etc. And they said that the Arrhenius constant basically comprises of the collision constant and the probability of correct collisions. Nice, right? थोड़ा उल्टा पड़ा अपन ने हिस्ट्री में. This is how things went forward. We have studied them in the opposite chronological order. भव्या, इट्स गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इन द अपकमिंग वीक, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. ठीक है दोस्तों, सो इस चीज को पूरा थोड़ा समराइज करेंगे आगे जाके. सेम थिंग इज गिवन ओवर हियर इन दिस पेज एज वेल. या सो आर्हेनियस इक्वेशन, प्रोबेबिलिटी फैक्टर इज बेसिकली प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट द कोलिजन इज प्रॉपरली अलाइंड. सो रिएक्शन रेट इज कोलिजन फ्रीक्वेंसी, एनर्जी फैक्टर, प्रोबेबिलिटी फैक्टर, जेड इंटू ए बी इंटू एफ इंटू पी, सब कट कुट आके बच जाएगा. के इज इक्वल टू ए टू द पावर माइनस ए इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस ए बाय आर टी. Where A is your frequent collision factor into probability. Arrhenius constant is also called the pre-exponential factor. So, bas ho gaya. Arrhenius equation is done. नाउ यू मस्ट बी वंडरिंग सर थोड़े सवाल करा दो आर हीनियस के, प्लीज सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस ऑफ आर हीनियस इक्वेशन. डोंट वरी, वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस ऑन फ्राइडे. फ्राइडेज क्लास ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज गोना बी ऑल अबाउट क्वेश्चंस. ऑन फ्राइडे द क्लास ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स विच वी विल हैव एट 7 PM और 8 PM डिपेंड्स. या वॉट वी विल डू इन दैट क्लास इज वी विल सॉल्व अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. थ्योरी ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज ओवर. वॉट यू कैन डू टूडे is go open the NCERT, solve all the questions. So let me ask you guys for a promise. Ek chota sa promise mang lu aapse. Can I please? Yeah, guru dakshina bol lo usko. By Friday, okay, this is your homework. By Friday, solve all NCERT questions of chemical kinetics. Can you please do it? A request from my side. Yeah, if you will, then please write promise over here. Yeah, in the chat box, if you will do it, write promise. On Friday, I want to feel that you guys already know how to solve the questions. I will solve questions with you. We will try to take as many as possible. 5, 10, 15 jitne bhi ho sakte hain, depending on the level of the questions. We'll try to do a number of questions. I want to see it in you that you're already able to do all of them. Cool. So very nice. Juhi is saying that we promise. Lakshya, yes, that will be more than enough to solve previous year questions, man. Yeah. Chalo, badiya. Tushar is saying promise. Neeraj is saying pehle hi ho gaya. Chalo, badiya. Tejaswini, very good. Mohammed, kahan chala gaya, bhai? Tumhara naam gayab ho gaya. Chalo. Anyway, very nice. बलदीप वेरी गुड. प्रियांशिनी प्रिया बहुत बढ़िया. सिद्धार्थ यस एग्जाम्पल्स एंड एक्सरसाइजेस बोथ ऑसम ऑसम ऑसम. एवरीवन इज गिविंग मी दैट, एवरीवन इज टेलिंग मी दैट दे विल डू इट. गुड जॉब पीपल. सो द थिंग इज थ्योरी फॉर केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज डन. या देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड सूडो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शंस. इफ यू हैव अ डाउट इन दैट जस्ट रीड इट फ्रॉम द एनसीईआरटी. अदरवाइज आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट ऑन फ्राइडे एज वेल इफ यू हैव अ डाउट. इट्स वेरी सिंपल आइडिया. ओके, एक छोटा सा आइडिया दे देता हूँ. या वेरी क्विकली आई विल गिव यू एन आइडिया. ओपनिंग ऑफ एस्टर्स. ओके, लेट्स थिंक अबाउट एन एस्टर. सो यू हैव CH3, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ, सिंगल बॉन्ड ओ CH3. कैन यू सी दैट दिस इज एन एस्टर एंड व्हेन इट रिएक्ट्स विद वाटर it will give you basically your acid and alcohol once again. ठीक है. And consider this to be an elementary reaction. Okay, consider this to be an elementary reaction. Can I say that the rate is equal to, okay, some rate constant into concentration of the ester into concentration of water? Now, my dear friends, if I take water in excess, मान लो मैंने पानी बहुत सारा ले लिया. या I take 2 crore moles of water. Okay, lots of water. Out of that, only 3 moles are being used. Okay, this is only 3 moles. Let's say I have so many moles of water. Out of that, only 3 moles are being used. Can you imagine that the concentration of water will almost be a constant value? This is as good as a constant. Yeah, if this is an elementary reaction, this is the rate law that I can write using the law of mass action. Concentration of this guy depends what we've taken. Concentration of this guy excess. So since this is in excess, even if you use a few molecules of water to do this reaction, it was already in excess, it will still be in excess. Infinity minus 2 is still infinity. Yeah, so concentration of water, since it is in excess, is as good as a constant value. So my dear friends, can I just combine this guy and this guy to make a new constant? Can I write over here that rate is equal to k dash into the concentration of the ester, where k dash is equal to original rate constant into the concentration of water? Yes. So do you realize that because of us keeping one of the reactants in excess, kyunki humne ek cheez ko excess mein rakha, our second order reaction is acting like a first order reaction. second order reaction. This thing is as good as a constant, so it acts like a first order reaction. Such cases are known as pseudo first order reactions. Okay, pseudo bolo to fake. You have heard about pseudopodia, right? Fake feet wale jo organisms hote hain. Cool. So this is what is pseudo first order reaction, in case you guys did not know about it. So there are a lot of questions that come in JEE mains and NEET about esters. So you have to know already that they will act as a pseudo first order reaction only, because water is always taken in excess. Done. Pradyumna, we have done a lot of chapters, my friend. So for 11th class, we have already covered the chapters of atomic structure, periodic properties, chemical equilibrium, states of matter, that is gaseous state, thermodynamics, and chemical equilibrium is going on. And in 12th class, we have done all of organic chemistry. We have done classes, one short class on biomolecules and polymers, which are as good as full classes for those chapters. And we have done in physical chemistry, solid state. And और कौन सा किया भैया सॉलिड स्टेट के बाद शायद यही कर रहे हैं एम और एम आई फॉरगेटिंग समथिंग आई थिंक दिस इज द वन दैट वी आर डूइंग आफ्टर सॉलिड स्टेट या सो दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट वी हैव डन ऑन दिस चैनल राइट नाउ जस्ट गो टू द प्लेलिस्ट सेक्शन यू विल सी एग्जैक्टली व्हाट हैज बीन डन चलो जी सो दोस्तों दैट्स इट फॉर टुडेज क्लास ओके एट 9:15 आई हैव अ लाइव सेशन विद यू एंड आई विल टेल यू गाइज हाउ आई क्लियर्ड माय बैकलॉग्स व्हेन आई वाज प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर माय जी back in 2009 and 2010 theek hai ji cool so Devu I would suggest Cengage for that Cengage is a very good book targets lots of questions in a short span of time so to build that speed for NEET because in NEET you need a lot of speed to solve questions so many questions in 1 hour so that's a suggestion from my side for NEET karke dekh lo theek hai सिद्धार्थ कैटलिस्ट में यार कुछ नहीं होता एक्टिवेशन एनर्जी कम हो जाती है इट प्रोवाइड्स एन अल्टरनेटिव पाथवे ओके सो इट्स लाइक दिस ए हैज टू रिएक्ट विद बी इट हैज टू कोलाइड विद दिस द कैटलिस्ट ओके विल कम इन द मिडल विद द कैटलिस्ट देर आर मल्टीपल वेज ऑफ इट्स ईजी टू कोलाइड विद द कैटलिस्ट बेसिकली कैटलिस्ट एक फट्टा सा होगा या दिस गाय कोलाइड्स ईजिली द अदर गाय कोलाइड्स ईजिली देन द कैटलिस्ट लीव्स ओके डू यू गेट द आइडिया थोड़ा आइडिया लग गया होगा दैट्स ऑल द कैटलिस्ट डज ओके लेट्स से दिस गाय हैज टू रिएक्ट विद दिस गाय इसको आई से ही आना पड़ेगा ओके सो देयर आर सो मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ कोलिजंस पॉसिबल ओनली वन कोलिजन लाइक दिस व्हाट अ कैटलिस्ट डज इज इट प्रोवाइड्स अनदर अल्टरनेट पाथवे दिस गाय कैन इजिली कोलाइड विद द कैटलिस्ट बिकॉज इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सर्फेस एरिया कैटलिस्ट इज मोस्टली अ सर्फेस फिनोमेना सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट सिंस इट हैज अ लॉट इज इट हैज अ ह्यूज सर्फेस एरिया दिस गाय कैन ऑल्सो कोलाइड इजिली एंड देन द कैटलिस्ट जस्ट लीव्स गिविंग यू द प्रोडक्ट That is basically how catalyst helps. You can read about it from the NCERT. So catalyst lowers the activation energy. As simple as that. Okay? So activation energy hi kam ho gaya. So already lots of molecules will contain that energy. That's all. Chalo. So Neelam, I suggest you to leave a comment down below. I think you have done that already, but I will get back to you very soon. ठीक है सो दोस्तों दैट्स इट फ्रॉम माय साइड फॉर दिस क्लास थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग इन इफ यू एंजॉयड द क्लास मेक श्योर हिट दैट लाइक बटन शेयर इट अराउंड बिकॉज वी लर्न केमिस्ट्री ओवर हियर इन अ डिफरेंट अनकन्वेंशनल मैनर इट्स नॉट सिमिलर टू हाउ एवरीवन डज इट सो इन केस यू एंजॉय दिस मेथड ऑफ टीचिंग मेक श्योर यू शेयर इट अराउंड मेक श्योर यू स्प्रेड द वर्ड एंड स्टे सब्सक्राइब बिकॉज वी विल कम बैक विद मोर एंड मोर क्लासेस फॉर यू एट 9:15 आई एम गोना टेल यू हाउ आई क्लियर्ड माय बैकलॉग्स ड्यूरिंग माय जेई प्रिपरेशन सी यू देन अंटिल नेक्स्ट टाइम टेक केयर